All right, I want to talk about a verse that I ran into not long ago. I don't know where it's from, but basically it says something like this. Render to me your heart, not your garments. That's what the I Am says. Meaning, he doesn't want you to sacrifice yourself. He doesn't care about your flesh and blood body. He's not interested in your garments, okay? Meaning, your suit, your earthly suit. He doesn't care about you putting it through the meat grinder or whatever. You know what he really wants? Your heart. Give him your heart. How do you give somebody your heart? Well, it says if you love him, you keep his commandments, right? And that is what love is, keeping his commandments. But not on your own effort in a court, no. It's through his spirit that he gives to you that enables you to walk in righteousness, okay? That helps you develop, transform, so on and so forth. So he doesn't care about, your garments, if you're willing to go through tribulation, put your head in the chopping block. He desires mercy, not sacrifice, okay? He doesn't want your sacrifice, doesn't want you to sacrifice yourself, okay? He wants you to give him your heart, okay? Follow his ways, okay? Follow the higher law through the spirit, okay? And yes, it's being more gentle, more loving, and that type of stuff. Getting rid of that brutish, Gentile, Hamitic spirit of strife, contention, barbarianism, and that stupidity, okay? So anyways, yeah, that's all I wanted to throw out there. I was going to say something else, I forgot. But anyways, maybe it's a good thing I forgot. Yes, he desires your heart, okay? Your obedience is better than sacrifice, okay? Better than animal sacrifice. Better than self-sacrifice. You see, the wicked want bloodshed. The realm of death and Hades want blood, okay? That's why they want to trick you in your mind to do something stupid, right? Just so they could keep control of things. Some would say even the Gentiles, the false light of these Olympians, all right? These Grecians, these Edomites, the Mount of Edom. But yeah, it's all there encoded in scripture if you could read between the lines, all right? There's a lot of entities talking through the scriptures, but if you know how to discern who's who and what's what, then it shouldn't be a problem, all right? So don't fall into the deception, all right? Of bloodshed and blood flow and destruction. No. They're hoping that we, you know, engage in that so they can have an excuse to say, you see, they can't ascend, they can't evolve because humans are flawed. You see, they're tricked. They could be deceived, this, that, and the other. It's just, you know, they're grasping at straws. They're looking for anything, even minute, to just point the finger at you and excuse themselves of their own stupidity and way of being. So anyways, that's all I got for this video. Continue in the faith, walk in the spirit, agree with Christ, Savior number 12. And, yeah, if you love him, you'll keep his commandments, okay? Love your neighbor as yourself. If you love your neighbor, you wouldn't harm him. Unless you're one of these stupid Gentiles or heathen Hamites or two-third house of Israel reprobates. Anyways, I'm out. Peace.